It's Jerry and Jill Sterich. Number 61, Joe Conklin, along with Xavier Dekmer. Parents Jim and Laura Conklin.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Kohler High Schooler. Tonight, KLC hosts Random Lake in conference action. Hello, everybody. I'm Chris Wright, the coach. Mike Martin is down in Florida with his family at Disney World, so I decided to get my son, Tommy Wright, to join me tonight. Tom, thanks for joining us tonight. Tom, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself before we have the game tonight?
As I said, I'm his son. My name's Tommy Wright. Just graduated from Oshkosh. I played football here at Sheboygan. I kind of know the area really well. I know the teams well, and I'm excited for the time here.
Number 68.
All right, Tom, thanks for everything. I know that tonight, Kohler comes in at 0-4, Random Lake at 1-3. I know you played on some pretty tough teams at North that struggled a little bit. What do you do as a coach to keep your kids motivated, and what did you guys do as players to keep yourselves motivated when things weren't going so well?
Well, Coach Sablocki's got to stay with us. Keep the team together, keep it unified. Even if it's not building for this week and next week, we got plenty of weeks left in the year to keep going. And in the future, keep them all together. Hey, you don't want to lose any of your pieces.
Yeah, that's a big thing, and it's always tough. We're at the halfway point of the season. KLC, they've already played three of the top four teams in the league, which is really a tough thing for them. So maybe the lighter teams are better. So maybe tonight they can catch a team like Random Lake.
Pioneer team and their parents.
Good for it,
so
right now we got parent night and everyone's here ready to go.
Parents, thank you for
now they got a senior quarterback, but we talked about it the last time. We got a pretty young squad here. What does the 11 seniors, do for the younger guys and to get them into that winning, attitude?
Explain the plays as they happen. Right after a play happens, talk about what they saw, what happened, what did you see, and then next time, because coaches like to stick with plays that work, and that's something that you're going to see. Next time, try to get the stuff over the wood on a pass play, a run play, try something different. Tell them what they saw.
Well, I think one of the things that tonight is the key is obviously playing a team that's not as good. Got to take care of the football, always a key in football, taking care of the ball, not too many turnovers, and not allowing probably big plays as well.
With the field and the weather conditions, big plays could obviously be a factor right now. Not too wet, not too dry. Oakland's going to be a good game.
Well, thanks so much for your intro there. When we return, we're going to have the starting lineup and the kickoff for tonight's ball game. Thanks, Greg. No interviews. Too many mosquitoes.
Perfect. How long for PSA? We'll be off camera for about 1 minute. First.
In this spot.
Okay.
In this spot.
Alright, I'll call
safety first.
They could be dangerous. I think we should call animal control.
Animal control?
To be safe.
Don't worry. I got this. It's a new model. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection. They need you. You're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
All right, good evening, everybody. It's football time here at Evan Field. Welcome to a Big East Conference football game between your 2018 Pioneer football team and the visitors from Random Lake. Kohler High School and the WIA require good sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators at education-based interscholastic events. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. For the enjoyment and respect of all in attendance, your cooperation in demonstrating positive sportsmanship are expected, and thank you very much. The officials for tonight's game, Larry McCann, back judge. Jerry Stylin, line judge. John Lucila, head linesman. Michael Backus, umpire, and the crew chief and referee this evening, Bill Backus. They've been assigned by the Big East Conference, so welcome, gentlemen, and thank you for being here. Kohler Middle School student, Grant Cassidy.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Great job, Grant. Thank you very much for getting us off on the right foot this evening. And now for the starting lineups. First, for the visiting Random Lake Rams, they come out together. So welcome your 2018 Random Lake Rams. Christopher Pocky.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
No thanks, Dad. I got it.
Okay. I'm gonna go fix the lamp in your room.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you.
quick update on baseball again. Top of the third, Brewers up 3-0 on the Pirates. Dodgers up 1-0 on the Cardinals, and an interesting twist of events. The Reds up 2-0 on the Cubbies.
You make me wear my bike helmet.
Taught me never to run with scissors.
And to follow the swimming rules.
You tell me to stay away from drugs.
To always buckle my seatbelt.
So why do you keep a loaded gun in your drawer?
How safe is that?
You ask them to follow some safety rules, now they're asking you. In fact, they're counting on you. Never let your gun get into the wrong hands. Remember, always lock it up. Visit ncpc.org.
Traditional light bulbs actually generate 9 times more heat than light. Switch to Energy Star light bulbs, and you'll realize just how much cash you are really burning through. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
Got a quarter?
Okay, hi, my name's Tim Bull. I'm a ISA certified arborist with the city of Sheboygan. I've been working here about a year. One of the primary focuses of my job is to treat the ash trees. The emerald ash borer is an insect that's been in Wisconsin for over 10 years, and it's working its way kind of north from southern Wisconsin. It's been found in Sheboygan for a few years now. It's been around, and the focus is for the city to try to save the ash trees before they all die. There's about 5,000 ash trees on the street, between the street and the sidewalk, and just to give you a sense, there's about 20 to 23,000 trees between the street and the sidewalk, so 5,000 of those are ash trees. So it's important for the city to not let all those trees die at the same time. So the emerald ash borer is an insect where it gets in the tree, it lays eggs, the eggs hatch and burrow under the bark, and they basically suffocate the tree as they feed. Now it takes a number of years before you'll see an effect from the insect. But the important thing is, when you're trying to save an ash tree, is to treat it with an insecticide before you see the tree declining. Because by the time you see the effects that the tree's dying, it could be too late. Sometimes it's not too late, but many times the damage is already done and can't be repaired. So it's more of a preventative measure that we're doing. And I've been treating ash trees for about 6 years now. I've seen it work. I've seen where I've treated a tree. I came back 2 years later, treated the same tree again, and the tree was still healthy, but maybe the neighbor's trees that were untreated were almost dead. So I believe in it, and research backs it up. It's supposed to be over 96% effective. As far as the city's plan, their plan is to treat half the ash trees and remove half the ash trees, because it's expensive either way you want to look at it. If you want to remove them all, it's a huge expense. If you want to treat them all, it's very expensive. So a kind of compromise is to try to save half, remove half over a three-year period. So this year, 2017, I've treated between 1,100 and 1,200 ash trees to date. And over the next year and over the next 2 years, we'll get to that 2,500 mark where we've potentially saved half the trees. Now, the city's doing a three-year treatment process where every 3 years we'll have to retreat if we want the tree to continue to survive. And right now the insecticide that we're using, the active ingredient is emamectin benzoate. There's a number of different products that contain that. It's labeled for 2 years, where every 2 years you should retreat, but a lot of research is saying you can get at least 3 years out of it, so that's why the city's gone with the three-year plan. Well, first of all, the process of picking which trees to save and which trees not to save really stems from, is the tree in a good location to begin with? So if we're only going to save half the ash trees, we want to save the ones that are in a good spot versus the ones that are not an ideal spot. So we look for medians, grass areas between the road and the sidewalk that are at least 6 feet wide. This one here that we're in is probably more like 8 feet. And we want to look for spots where there's no overhead power lines that the tree's growing into, or if the tree is really buckling up the sidewalk or something like that, maybe that's not an ideal tree to save. So once we determine which trees we want to save, the process is pretty simple. We drill into the tree with a little smaller than a pencil size hole, and a tree will take anywhere from 4 holes to, I had one this year that I had 10 holes in. So average, I would say 6 or 7 drills about an inch under the bark. And then those holes get filled up. You put an injection tee in each one of those holes, so it's all sealed. And each one of those tees is connected with a small hose, which all stems back to a bottle which has the insecticide in it. Now, the tree, the amount of insecticide that's used depends on the tree size. So the rate the city uses is 5 milliliters. Per diameter inch of the tree. Now, diameter is measured at breast height, 4.5 feet above ground. Okay, yeah, so this tree here is 18 inches in diameter. So 18 times 5 is 90 milliliters that this tree requires. So as we're going down a street, I have a guy helping me. He measures them. He records what's going to be used. He records the address where the tree is. And I get to the tree, and I get to work drilling, setting it up, measuring the chemical that's going in, and once I get it all set, it's just a matter of pressurizing the container, the bottle with the insecticide, to get that insecticide to the tree. And really, it's just a bike pump that I'm using to pressurize, and I give it about 30 pounds of pressure, and that'll get the insecticide to the tree, and it's up to the tree to take it in. So every tree is different. Some trees take it right in, some trees are a little slower. Sometimes you don't get that uptake. The tree just refuses to suck anything up. So then that's a sure sign that the tree is too far gone, and there's no point in trying to save that tree. So once I have it all set up and pressurized, it's up to the tree to take it in. And really, I could increase the pressure to 40 pounds, even 50 pounds, but it isn't going to make a difference how fast the tree takes it in. It's really, the pressure is just getting the chemical to the tree. And once the lines, the hoses are all clear, so you can see the blue, the chemical is blue, you can see it going in. And once those lines are all emptied out, then you can undo the pressure and unhook the tree, and that's all that needs to be done. Now, everything, when we leave a tree that we've treated, we got a can of blue spray paint. We put a dot on the street side of the tree, roughly 2-3 feet off the ground, and that is a symbol that we've treated that ash tree, that we plan on saving that ash tree. And we'll also put a pesticide sign down that says keep off pesticide. That's something that needs to be done. It's required by the the pesticide regulations for the state. So those signs will leave for a day and we'll pick them up the next day. But the blue dot will stay, so we'll always know that that tree was treated in 2017. As far as danger to people walking by or anything like that with the pesticide that we're using, the word is caution on the label of this insecticide, which is the lowest toxicity. Really, it's not much to worry about since it's all going right into the tree itself. There's nothing going to be on the grass or in the air or anything really to worry about as far as that goes. As soon as I leave the tree and the blue dot will stay there, but nothing else will be there, that tree is safe to be around.
Mom, can we get some ice cream?
Please, Mom, please.
No, we're having dinner soon.
Please. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just...
Kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs.
Totally.
Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls. But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you guys know statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Yeah. That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child...
There's one thing you can never have sex without.
It's not something you buy.
Or something you take.
In fact, there's only one way to get it.
It has to be given to you, freely.
It's consent.
Because sex without it isn't sex.
It's rape. Consent.
If you don't get it, you don't get it. It's on us to stop sexual assault.
Learn how and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
Hey, you going out like that?
Yeah, why?
Well, what would the neighbors think?
I see you! Come look at Mr. Feather!
Look what I have.
Mr. Bird, remember? Bark, bark, bark! We're just playing! We're just playing! I'm trying to get you out of here!
Even still.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection.
We'll be right back.